Users in Umbraco are people who have access to the Umbraco back office. So, who's a user? How is it different from a member? A user is someone who has access to the Umbraco back office. A member does not have access to the Umbraco back office. As a user, when you enter your Umbraco project, you'll find that a user is already created with the email and password provided during creation of the project. You can create, edit, and manage users in the user section of the back office. Once logged into the back office, a user cannot be deleted. They can only be disabled. The reason is there could be content associated with the user and we would not want to delete that content or cause any errors. My name is Isha and in this video, we'll look at how to create users from the back office. So, let's get started. To start off, let's create a user from the back office. We'll go to the users section and here you'll see an overview of all the current back office users. You can filter users by its status such as active, disabled, invited or inactive, or by user groups, or order the users by name, oldest users, newest users and last logged in users. You can also view the users in list view by clicking on the grid icon here. If you have a long list of users, you can search for a user by typing the name in the search bar. These are some of the features available on the user management screen. To create a new user, let's click on the Invite User button. In the Invite User screen, we'll add in some details like name, email, user group, and message. Let's say our new user is Jack Smith. And I'll enter his email down here. I now need to select which user group the new user should be added to. Let's click on Add. The different user groups are displayed. I'll cover these user groups in the next video. For now, let's say my new user belongs to the editors group and click Submit. Finally, let's enter a message for the invitation. I'll write, "Hey Jack, will you join me on my project?" Cool. Now that we've filled in all the required details, let's hit the Send Invite button. And as it says on the screen, an invite has been sent to Jack using the email that we had provided. In this invite, Jack will find a link which will verify his email and let him set up a password for his new user on our website. Once Jack has set a password, he will be sent to the back office of this website. Now, let's go back to the users. And you'll see that Jack has been added as an editor to the website. Clicking on Jack's user profile, we can edit a few default properties, such as the language of the menu and dialogues Jack will see when logged into the back office. Change and remove the user photo. Currently, we see the delete user option because the status is invited. Once the user accepts the invitation and the status changes to active, this option will change to disable user access. Assign him to different user groups and assign the start notes for both content and media sections to limit his access in the back office. If you've made any changes to the user profile, click Save. And that's how easy it is to create a new user. In the next video, I'll cover the different user groups, how to create a new user group, and customize its properties. Thanks for watching this video.